fight in the final seconds of the Crosstown Shootout, leading to several suspensions. Good evening, everyone, and thanks for joining us. I'm Curtis Fuller. The debate tonight is the punishment. Is it severe enough? Here's a look at what both schools handed down today. UC losing four players, including Yancey Gates, who was seen throwing several punches. He'll sit for six games. Xavier also losing four players, but the most severe suspensions only lasting four games. The Musketeers' star player, Tu Holloway, getting just one game. News 5's Laura Borchers joins us live tonight with more on the punishment and what's being said on both campuses. Laura?
Curtis, we spent time at the University of Cincinnati and Xavier tonight in the wake of this fight. They're echoing the same word over and over: embarrassment.
I think it was kind of like embarrassing for the city as a whole.
I think it was unfortunate. Like, I don't think it needed to happen.
It's embarrassing, and it's what neither of these institutions stand for.
The sucker punch landed on Xavier's Kenny Freeze, but players threw heated words back and forth the entire game. The eruption abruptly ended the Crosstown Shootout. Now Xavier's first words are an apology.
You know, yesterday, America saw an ending to a basketball game that sickened a lot of us, including me. Has no place in college athletics. It's not who we are.
Four players on each team were slapped with suspensions. Tu Holloway will sit out one game, and he's now trying to explain his post-game comments, calling his teammates gangsters.
We're not thugs. Like, we're not doing things in the streets and things like that. That's what I'm not trying to mean that term, but we're just toughness like that. That's what I mean by gangsters, toughness.
After saying he chose the wrong words to express himself, Holloway spoke to kids watching the game.
And I really apologize for what they're saying, because, you know, they just want to watch a great basketball game. And unfortunately, they saw things that's not supposed to happen on a basketball court.
It hits close to home for Coach Mack.
The ending embarrasses me. It's really difficult to explain to my 5- and 6-year-old girls why a fight ensued at the end of the game.
Mack said he wishes he hadn't given players the mic after the game. Students do, too.
I do think it was a mistake that Tu and Mark Lyons were able to speak in front of everybody after that, especially in their Xavier jerseys, because that's not what we are.
It's a heated rivalry. It came down to it. We beat them by 20 last year. They beat us by 20. Walk out as men, accept it, and just walk on.
Kenny Freeze had an x-ray. No breaks, no fractures. He does have stitches on a couple of gashes, and he has swelling to heal up. But the good news, he did pass his vision test. Tomorrow, we plan to hear from UC and an afternoon press conference. Curtis?